Hello Bookish friends, welcome to another Bookish Talk video. In this video, I'm going to talk about why I DNF books. I very recently watched a video of booksellers in which they talked about the reasons that they DNF'd books. And I have a shelf called DNF in Goodreads. And I put the books that I DNF'd for sure in that shelf. There are some other books that I temporarily DNF'd and will come back in the future. But the ones in that shelf are the books that I certainly do not plan to go back. I categorized the 34 books in that shelf by the reasons why I DNF'd them. I tried to find the top 3 reasons why I DNF'd books, but there was a tie in the number of books for the reasons. So I can say that there are mainly 4 reasons why I DNF books. First reason is I DNF books because of a very disturbing character or a very disturbing theme, which I cannot force myself to read. I'm actually a very tolerant reader when it comes to gore, sex, torture, and violence. There are some themes that are beyond the red line for me. And the most disturbing theme for me is having sexual thoughts towards children and towards every woman that the male protagonist meets. This was the case for Zorba the Greek. Alexis Zorba was a man who liked to live his life to the fullest, but he had sexual thoughts towards every woman that he met, and he regarded women according to their attractiveness, which was a no-no for me. So I of course DNF'd the book, and the character in the Ghostwriter by Philip Roth was thinking that I will marry this girl when she grows up. I will wait for 8 years. She's only 12, but I will certainly marry her. And that was the time that I DNF'd the book. Another very disturbing thought is to be in the thoughts of a racist character. And the Turkish non-fiction book called Padişah Anaları was just a trash book. I don't usually call books trash. I try to respect the author because the author clearly spends time, experience, very thoughts into forming a book. But Padişah Anaları was an exception, and I will call this book trash. It had a reasoning that everything that the sultans in the Ottoman did wrong was because their mothers came from a different race than Turkish race. Actually threw the book to the garbage because it was trash. There are some other disturbing themes which made me DNF the books, but those were the two very distinctive ones. My other category with a very big number of books was that I did not care about the characters, the plot, or what is happening in the book. In American Gods by Neil Gaiman, I thought the character was so meh. I could care less about if he died, if he became king, if he became a god, or if he achieved sexual desires. I could care less. So it was a clear message that I should DNF the book. I like mysteries, but in The Picnic at Hanging Rock, even though there was a mystery involving young girls, because it was told in a very boring way, I said, who cares, and DNF'd the book. So, DNF'd a series because although I cared about the characters in the first two books, in the third book, I felt like whatever happens is fine with me, and it was pointless for me to continue the series. So I DNF'd Ramses, The Battle of Kadesh. And the tie was between the books with a humor that I do not like, and with books that I do not understand anything. I really did not like the humor in the Yulumine series. I actually DNF'd the book twice because I decided to give Illumine another chance because it was praised by so many of you. But once more, I hated the humor and I DNF'd the book. I also could not understand the humor. I'm not going to say I could not understand the plot, but I could not understand the humor in The Hitchhiker's Guide to Galaxy. So it was a waste of time for me. And I also really hated the humor in The Sideways Stories from Wayside School, which was a middle grade book. I dislike books that promote cruelty to children, even if it is towards evil characters. I could not get along with the theme, and I DNF'd that book too. Lastly, but of course not least, I will talk about books that I clearly did not have an idea of what is going on. The first one was Through the Looking Glass. I could hardly finish Alice's Adventures in Wonderland. At the time that I was reading, because I was not a DNFer, maybe because it's a thin book, I should finish Through the Looking Glass and done with the series. But that book was even weirder than the first one. I understood even less things, so it was pointless for me to continue with the book. Sexing the Cherry by Janet Winterson. This was a book club book, and many of my friends really loved the book and said that it had very important themes. But I didn't understand a single thing when I read the book. And it is the book that I DNF'd at the earliest page. As for Gollum, I understood the words and what is happening, but I failed to make a connection between the sentences. So it was clearly a waste of time for me to keep listening to this book. Those were the reasons that I DNF'd books. In the previous years that I have been in BookTube, I DNF'd more and more books because I have received many recommendations from all of you. And I have so many books to read. My main motto is not to waste time reading books that I do not feel anything or I do not want to read. And when I look at the statistics, I actually see that I read more books by DNFing more books. It is not like I am the queen of DNF or anything like that, but it helps me to try new genres, new writing styles much more freely, because I know I will DNF the book if I do not want to read it or do not feel the book. So as last words, I can say that DNFing books has helped me to enjoy my reading experience much, much more. And I would strongly advise you to DNF books, because no one will come to your house and accuse you of not finishing a book. So please comment down below about the reasons that you DNF books. And if you're a new viewer, first of all, welcome. Please like and subscribe. Hope to see you very soon. Bye! Turkish word of the day, I'm going to choose racist. Racist means ırkçı in Turkish, and ırkçı is our Turkish word of the day. Have a good day.